Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and a warm welcome to Norwich Cathedral for the next in our series of lunchtime organ concerts. It's wonderful today to be able to look forward to this concert given by Robbie Carroll, our wonderful assistant organist. Robbie has been assistant organist with us since October 2022, but this in fact is his first organ recital here, because when he first joined us, of course, there was no pipe organ to play whilst the cathedral organ was undergoing its rebuilding. And since we've been able to relaunch our organ concerts at the start of 2024, we're very much looking forward to his performance today. Those of you who are regular members of our congregation and community will have enjoyed Robbie's wonderful playing in our worship here over many months, and it'll be lovely to hear some of his music today. On the back of your programme, you'll find details of other forthcoming concerts taking place at the cathedral here. On the 21st of March, we welcome Dr. David Flood, who was formerly organist and master of the choristers at Canterbury Cathedral, and now a proud resident of Norfolk. It'll be wonderful to welcome him to give the next lunchtime organ concert. And now that we are into the season of Lent, you'll find on the cathedral website details of all of the Holy Week and Easter music taking place at the cathedral, including a performance by the Cathedral Choir of Bach's great St. John Passion, first performed in 1724, in fact. So a wonderful way to commemorate that important anniversary. Details of how to get tickets for that are on the back of your programme. And there are many other musical events taking place throughout Holy Week and into Easter. On the evenings in Holy Week, we have short musical recitals that take place following the evening Eucharist and Address. And organ concerts, as well, of course, as the many choral services that take place throughout that time. So do have a look at what's on offer there. If you are able to make a contribution to the Oratorian Collection as you leave, then we're very, very grateful for that support. It enables us to continue to invite visiting organists to come and perform here and offer these organ recitals free of charge throughout the year. So thank you for your generosity in that regard. But for the time being, let's give a very warm welcome to our assistant organist, Robbie Carroll. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your very warm welcome. It is a real pleasure to be here to give my first recital here in post since I arrived here in October 2022. It's wonderful to have this really brilliant new pipe organ to play. It's been an absolute pleasure to sort of get to know its various sounds, and it's been very exciting. I must be possibly the only person in Norwich who never actually heard the old instrument. Many of the choristers and other people have described it to me, so it's a real pleasure to have the opportunity to play such a wonderful instrument. If I can be a bit bold and give one other welcome, I'd love to welcome anyone who is watching online, particularly anyone from Ireland. I believe my own family is tuning in from the west of Galway, despite my only giving them about an hour's notice of when this recital was taking place. So a very warm welcome to anyone here in person and online. So you've just heard the Chaconne in E minor by Dietrich Buxtehude, North German organ composer and contemporary of Bach's. You'll probably have picked up there are a lot of Chaconnes and Passacaglias in E minor in this program, so I hope you like that key. It's going to be quite a lot of it today. As I'm sure many of you know, a Chaconne or a Passacaglia is a musical form with a ground bass which repeats with variations that tend to increase in complexity as the piece goes on. It's become quite difficult over the years to establish the clear-cut difference between a Chaconne and a Passacaglia, with many musicologists and people disagreeing, and it has evolved quite a bit over the years. But I think the one consensus we can sort of come to is that in a Passacaglia, it's more likely that the theme beginning in the bass might move to some of the other parts. And you'll hear lots of that today. We are now in the season of Lent, so we are on our second day of Lent. So a Chaconne or a Passacaglia, you'll probably hear quite a few of them during this penitential time, as they tend to be slightly more serious musical forms. I'm going to now play a work by Anglo-Irish composer Charles Villiers Stanford. It's prelude in the form of a Chaconne, Opus 88, which is also in E minor. It's from a set which is not very often played, six preludes in various forms, and not very well-known music, but very beautiful. And I'll be playing the second from that set today. I'll then move on to play another Passacaglia by an American composer, this time Ned Roram, Passacaglia from his organ book number 3. Ned Roram passed away in 2022 in November, and I sort of feel that his death to a certain extent was a little bit overshadowed by the pandemic and the easing of restrictions, as we all had slightly different priorities at that particular time in history. He was born in Indiana. He had a very large output of all sorts of instrumental forms, but he's particularly known for his art songs. He wrote over 500 of these. He had a very close personal relationship also with Leonard Bernstein. So the Passacaglia I'm going to play for you today, it's a 12-tone work written in 1989, and it's quite interesting. The score is a little bit of a blank slate. There is only a metronome mark. There are no dynamics, no performance instructions at all. So I've decided to make what I can of it with very little instructions. But first we'll hear some Stanford. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You'll be relieved to know the next two pieces are very tonal. So I'm going to continue with a little bit of Bach, one of the pieces from his Great 18, or his, also known as his Leipzig Chorale Preludes, Schmücke dich, o liebe Seele, which translates as Adorn thyself, thy soul with gladness. It's a very well-known and popular Lenten chorale prelude of Bach's, and possibly one of his most beautiful and one of his best-known. It's also the only piece in this programme not based on a Chaconne or a Passacaglia. It's from a set which Bach put together in his final decade, but from earlier works which he had composed while at Weimar, and it's a very sort of a very varied collection of different styles and forms. I think with this piece, it's almost very reminiscent of chamber music. You could easily picture a sort of a cello playing the bass line, a pair of flutes trilling away in the accompaniment, and a very beautiful solo instrument, perhaps an oboe d'amore playing the very heavily ornamented chorale theme. Though today instead we have the great open diapason 8 number 2, which I'm sure will be just as lovely. I'll finish today's recital with a final introduction in Passacaglia, again in E minor, in case you haven't had enough of that key just yet. It's from a German composer, Josef Reinberger, who has a huge output of choral and instrumental works, and is particularly known for his 20 organ sonatas. The work was not originally envisaged as an introduction into Passacaglia. It uses sections of his most famous organ sonata, number 8 in E minor, and it seems to have become a little bit of a style of the day to use the first page of the first movement, which happens to segue quite nicely into the final movement, as some of the material used in the first movement features again at the end of the piece. I do think it is a little bit of a shame that the full sonata isn't heard more often, as it's a very fine piece of music, so I feel a little bit hypocritical today for only playing the introduction and Passacaglia, but I would thoroughly recommend listening to the rest of the work. It's a very, very fine piece of music. I'd like to thank you all very much for attending today's recital. It has really been an absolute pleasure to get to know this really beautiful instrument over the last few months, and I'm sure there will be lots more great playing to hear over the coming weeks. So for now, some Bach and Reinberger. Thank you.